Ollie Murs is with me. Good morning, Ol.
Good morning, Tao. How are you?
Look at you. You're fresh-faced and energetic.
I don't feel very fresh-faced this morning.
I mean, you're all over the place like a cheap suit, aren't you?
I am, yeah, if you put it like that, yeah. I was obviously in the X Factor last night.
Yeah.
And then, been a busy night.
And then you've done that awful Graham Norton.
Terrible show.
and you've just come back from Australia.
Yeah, I've just been there. I did my sellout tour over there, which was amazing. At the end of my tour, actually, I've been touring all year, so it's nice to be back in the UK. I do miss this country. When you leave it for a certain amount of time, you do miss it.
Well, tell me this: do you ever see your family at all?
I do get to see them quite a bit when I get back. I mean, you know, even though it's probably...
Have they forgotten what you look like?
Yeah. Well, every couple of weeks I go home for a couple of days and we have a catch up, and obviously it's always nice to see my mum and my dad and just talk about stuff. And I mean, I always hate ringing them. I mean, when you're away and you call someone, it's always never the same as seeing
them. No, you've got to see
them. It's nice to come home and see them. And always the smell of my house, my old house that I love. Mm. That's the...
What does it smell of?
I don't know, actually. Bob just smells of me. But no, it's just that family smell. We all have one, don't we? So when I go home, it's just nice to sort of be, you know, that sort of familiar, you know, the surroundings are the same as what I used to when I was growing up and stuff. So it's nice.
It brings you back to base.
Yeah, no, it definitely does.
Well, now you know. To refresh somebody who may have been up the Hindu Kush or down a hole in the ground for about 5 years, in 2009, you were the runner-up on X Factor. Now, since then, 4 number one singles, 3 multi-platinum selling hit albums. How, honestly, if you'd won the thing, what could you have achieved?
I could have done even better. No, I'm really pleased with the success. I think for me, it's all been down to the fans, really. I think the show gave me an amazing platform, and obviously I've been fortunate enough to write, I think, some good songs. But I think most importantly, the people who bought the records, you know, that's the key to all our success as artists.
There's a chance that they may like you.
Yeah, hopefully they like me. Yeah, you know, I'm just a down-to-earth nice guy, I think, from Essex, that's done all right. But no, I think the fact is, you know, the music, I think I've done really catchy, feel-good songs that people can smile to and relate to. And I think, I've been lucky enough, really. Like, you know, not many X Factor acts have success from the show. I mean, there's obviously been quite a few, but you know, there's only a handful of them, really. So the fact that the people have got behind me and supported me since the show's
runners up seem to do very well.
Yeah, I never quite know the formula why that is. There doesn't seem to be a really rhyme or reason. I don't know, because some of the winners have done well, but obviously me, One Direction, and I think JLS are the ones that everyone sort of talks about in terms of that.
Well, now you've completed your own United Kingdom Arena tour. Are you and Robbie Williams joined at the hip?
Well, we're just really good friends. I mean, you know, people know that I met Robbie on the show years ago on X Factor, and we've just kept in contact. And this new, you know, new album that he's done, and he's doing a swing album. And
well, you're on that, aren't you?
Yeah.
Swings both ways.
And he had this idea of doing I Want to Be Like You, King of the Swingers. And funny enough, it's a song that I used to sing years ago in the pub to my friends and when I used to do my own gigs. And so we did it the other night on Graham Norton, which was incredible. And, you know, we have a great chemistry. You know what, it's not a friendship that's fake. You know, it's just been done because we did a song together. Like, we generally get on really, really well. And we have a great chemistry and a great friendship.
Yeah, so tell us about the new album. Is it important to release new music, do you think?
Yeah, I mean...
Regularly?
Well, this year, I mean, I've done 3 albums in 3 years. I mean, this is my 4th year. Basically, I've always felt when I wrote the album, Right Place, Right Time, it had stamina and it had legs. I always felt there were some really good songs on it. And but the only reason we're doing this sort of special edition end of the year, because there was, you know, we wanted to put some bonus tracks on it, but generally for me, there was a DVD of the sellout tour that I felt was a really good thing for the fans and something for them to watch back. I mean, I've never done a DVD before, and it was the first tour, you know, real tour that I did that I was really proud of, and had this amazing footage, and I thought we could just get rid of it, but I thought, you know, it'd be great for the fans to see the show again, people that came to the O2. And I think it's, you know, hopefully it's the end of the album cycle now, and then after this album I'll be writing my new one for next year, which is...
Well, you'll be able to lie down in a darkened room for Christmas.
I've got 6 weeks off, so I'm hibernating. Yeah, I'm gonna go and find we're gonna go back to Essex in Witham and see my friends and family and spend lots of time there, really. So I'm just going to get a bit bit of normality back in my life a little bit.
Well, I know you've been tremendously busy, and it's been very kind, good of you to come in. And I know we can't ask you to sing because you've been singing your heart out, but maybe we can ask you to come.
Yeah, I would love to come back. I'm sorry we couldn't make it work this morning. Obviously, X Factor last night stuff, but I promise you, I'll be back definitely to do some songs.
We'll hold
you
for that, Holly.
I'd love to.
In the meantime, congratulations on all your success, and this, of course, is your latest.
Thank you,
Holly Moores.
Come on, come on, I'm right, I'm wrong, and when I'm wrong I say, we always had the good and bad, and that will never change. This is the closest I've ever been. And if you don't know, just put your hand on my heart. Put your hand on my heart, and you.